Hey guys, it's Tech Man Joe here at GDC again, and today I've got my buddy Justin Gobi Fields with us. So first off, let's tell them a little bit about who you are, what you do.
Okay. Alright, yeah. So I'm a concept artist in Hollywood, California, and we work on major motion pictures, TV, games, marketing, you name it. We're kind of a mercenary little art group that started about 4 years ago.
That's where the industry's going a lot, though. I mean, they're putting out a lot of their high-end content. They're actually tapping high-end artists like you to do concept work.
I mean, it's definitely become a very hybrid field where you have to know a little bit about 2D and 3D in order to get the job done and do it in a time frame which, you know, can fit the budget.
And you work both 2D and 3D?
I do, yes.
Awesome. So, I love the alien here.
Oh, thank you.
And his name is?
His name is Joe.
It's Joe. Anyway, so having worked with our historical devices, what can you tell me about the new Cintiq Pro systems?
You know, honestly, I think that the new Cintiq Pro systems, especially on the larger one with the 4K screen, is really, really great. I've been a big fan of the Mobile Studio Pro for a while now, as you know. I like all of the Wacom products in the sense of they're classy looking, they feel great, and they just work kind of flawlessly in that regard. You know, I've pretty much been using either a tablet or a Cintiq for like the last 8 years.
So, did you feel or notice a difference between the new pens and say everything you used?
Yeah, it's kind of hard to put it in words, but it feels like it's really, really smooth, and it does a lot of work in terms of making the transition from drawing to screen almost flawless.
So you hit on the fact that it's 4K.
Yeah.
Color, all of those things that we did behind the hood, under the hood, if you will. So you work with color, obviously.
Yeah.
The new displays obviously hit a higher color mark.
Yeah.
Do you use touch? It's okay.
Not as often as I'd like. But no, honestly, right now, for what we do, we don't really need the touch function, but it's also all personal preference. If you want to use it, you can use it. Just like the remote, you know? Like, if you want to use a remote, it's here. If you don't, you can put it off to the side. It doesn't matter.
Right. And, of course, the software can't develop for touch unless the hardware exists.
So, exactly.
So, to be fair, it's there. When the hardware gets there, we'll already be there.
Absolutely. Right. I mean, you guys innovate with every new product, and that's something that I really, really love.
What are the apps you use it in, and what do you love most about it in those apps?
I primarily use ZBrush, Photoshop, a little bit of KeyShot occasionally. I've been using a little bit of Modo as well. At the office, we do pretty much anything that gets the job done. We use it for Unreal, we use it for Premiere, we use it in Unity, Substance Painter. Megascans, we do all
that. You're using the pen outside of illustration. And, wow.
Because who has time to grab a mouse?
Thank you. I challenge you, when you go to move to your other applications, ask yourself why you're putting the pen down. Right?
Exactly.
Awesome. Justin, dude, get out of here. Love you, man.
Take
Thank you, guys.